Hi, this video is for a Audi A5 pillarless window where the window kept showing as if the door was open and would go up and down. The little 5mm you'll see that it closes there whenever it's not locked, okay? And then if you close it, it should lock up. My car was constantly going up and down as you're driving along. And it was because of a water ingress fault. This video will show you how to fix that. There are many videos that will show you how to take a door panel off. Essentially, you need to get a screwdriver with a bit of cloth padding under it. Clip this away from you. There's one screw and underneath here. You need to clip this section here off. Again, a screwdriver with a big bit of padding under it, just to tease it out. And then there'll be a screw here, and a screw here. There's also a screw just in here, and one right at the very, very bottom. That will allow you to, from the side, there's little poppers along the side. Again, screwdriver or a wide blade with a bit of protection, and then just press the door panel off. And then it lifts up. You unhook at the back of the door handle here. There's a little cable which just unhooks. And there's an electrical connector just underneath here, which you need to take off as well, which clamps on the module on the door. Then that whole panel lifts away and you're open to the door. When you're taking the lock out, you have to take this outer door lock mechanism off. Try not to do the handle, because the handle is connected to the bowser cable and the mechanism inside it. It's not the easiest to work with. I have done it before, but you're working sort of blind up inside. So basically, you pull the rubber back. There's two blue pop clips, one there, allows you to pull that rubber out. And there's a little cover hole here. I have a bit of red tape in mine. Here's a little bit of clear disc on it. Slip that off. Put an Allen key in. Screw out the little grub screw at 7 turns, and that'll allow you to pull that lock out that way. And then everything is just taking these two screws out here and unclipping the two cables off inside and removing the lock. The lock's out of the car, and you can see I'm going to take out 1, 2, 3 here, and see a third screw there. Take those three out first, pop this off, pull that out. I'm assuming that some moisture has still got into this. There goes. I'll take these screws out. Take this one out here. And then there's a fourth screw here. Before you can take this apart, there are two little levers. One here, a white one. And one here, a yellow one. And they may both be white, but in this case it's white and yellow. And basically all I'm going to do is stick a screwdriver behind it, tease it out until you just feel it pop a wee bit. And the same with this one. Not a big lot of force, because they're only plastic. So there you go, so it's popped a wee bit. So now that these are released a bit, you can probably see this little black O-ring there. I can press these a little bit more. There you go, it pops. Nice pop. So we can go ahead and pull this out carefully. Basically what you're trying to do is make sure that these all come out together. It's, you can build it up afterwards, but it's easier if you just pull it out together, because it's lots of these springs, and if you don't really know what way they go together, And it's definitely not the pen again afterwards. Okay. And I should just pull it. There you go. That's the two pens there you're trying to get out. Now they do have, I'll take a little zoom in here. So as you can actually see the orientation of these, the way they go. I'm not going to take them apart, but there is an orientation. So hopefully if you have attempted to do this and you pull it apart more than you need to, then this one plugs into this lever here, and this one plugs into this lever here. Okay. When the door closes, that releases and the window will go up. Whenever you open your door, this pushes in and your window comes down slightly. We're now going to take these series of screws out here. Gently prise these apart. Now that mine's covered in blue cement because I know these have problems with electricals. And as you can see, look, there's the moisture has been getting into the motor. So I obviously haven't seen it in around this area well enough. I can confirm that it is definitely a water's problem here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to dry this off, reseal it, and I'm going to seal it better than I think it did the last time. And this is a cheap Chinese one. The one from Audi is £120 plus VAT, and all this here comes sealed with like a plastic wax. So all the circuit boards are covered over. Cheap Chinese ones aren't covered over. I have previously put silicone over, or not silicone, this is Hylamar over the circuits, but I've obviously missed some. Take the two motors out, they just slot onto these positions here. Dry the whole circuit off with a hairdryer and set it in the radiator for an hour. And I've made a new seal around the perimeter with particular attention to here. This is where the water was getting in my last unit. And I've done the same with the closing cover. I put a seal around it as well. There is a weak pole in the outer cover, just here in the corner. So as you can see, I have actually deep filled all around here with Hylamar, making sure that the channels are clear here and here, and then there are the motors. Bloody you. And that. This is in there. And this one here. This center piece goes in like so. That, and then fix it under that. And you'll be able to get the gear wheels just. Okay, I have connected this arm back up to this and put the wee balance spring in there. All these are Vaseline and in line, and I have added some Vaseline just to the entry points of those two holes, which will help these two O-rings which are put in and help them waterproof seal. And now it's just a matter of reassembly. My units screw back together again. All screws are over. Regular switches are operational. And now I'm going to let it back and offer the two pins into these two holes of the metal bracket. So these are the two pins. And basically get them to line up. Them to line up with the holes, and then it should just slide together. Don't force it, just gently bring them together until. Okay. So they can go no further, but still, you can see the O-rings sitting popped out there, so There's one in. And there's the second one popped in. I'll just make sure that the arm's free. Put your screws back in again. I normally start with this screw again. Grey cover back on in here. A screw there and a screw there, and then we're ready to go out and test the unit again. Now the reinstall. I have already connected the inside cable with the inner shroud, which fits in this aperture. I've already fitted that. How you get this in through the top. Okay, so hooks in there, and now the next thing that it's advisable to do is the bowser cable for the outer lock. You can see it has a little slotted T on it. Hook it in now to it up. This would be a lot easier if I wasn't holding the phone as well. Just trying to show you guys how to do it. That slips in, and then you turn it 90 degrees anti-clockwise to get it to lock in. And then your lock is basically ready to lift up and turn into position. And you can see it here. And you have two holes to line up and two screws to put into that. Okay, two screws are in, so just now I just have to tighten them up. Two Torx screws. You can put a bit of thread lock on these if you wish, but generally you don't need to. They do come on. Okay, so that's your lock back into position. That's the easy part. Now, the hard part. We have this lovely, ingenious mechanism which Audi have come up with. And it basically channels, you can see it's from your outer door lock down to the inner door lock. And it's just what your lock mechanism follows through. But you have to stick your hand up inside and blind man. Located over the lock you just refitted, and there we go, and into position along with the outside lock. And then maybe you look from the outside through, you can see there's that wee plastic shroud inside, and the yellow bit is the what the key lock has to lock that into. The next awkward and fun bit is to get this lock and Mr. Floppy mechanism back fished in through here and located in with the lock and pushed into position. Key portion out of my lock. I've got my key fob. I'll just use it to inside. It's a whole pain in the backside putting it back together again. Okay, so once you have aligned this up, and it should, with a bit of a wiggle, just, there we go, lock in. Okay, so we come into this hole here, I'll use an Allen key, locating the wee grub screw there, and just tighten it up. It's
about 7 turns, and it locks the actual locking mechanism into position within the handle, so it doesn't come out. Okay, and then cover over the little hole again. I just use a bit of tape. Did come with a wee circular tab, and then these two little blue clip back in there. Okay, the
electrical cable then just connects on the inside. There's a wee dumple there which lines up with the starter. Just now you can see a register click of the motor means it's worked. Yeah. Reinstall this right here. And slip the electrical cable underneath that. Okay.
Okay, so that's us back together again. I'm now just going to test the door from the outside before I put the panel back on, just to make sure it all is good. Let me just show you this. It's only 5 mm of a drop. Okay, now we'll put the inside panel back on. It's your inner door handle cable. Hooks on to the door handle lever here. It's in there. Pull it back. And then slide over. And then this tooth bit here clips over the end, which plugs into this control module. And simply pull that lever down. And that's us. Hook your door panel over the top of the door. Make sure that it's seated down. And then on the little tabs here, these little plugs with the white tips, they should line under the door. Just tap those in. Door panel hung back on again. We have a screw to put in here, here, in here, one in here, and one right at the very bottom of the door, here. The next stage is to reassemble this cover back on here. It just plugged back in to the unit. So, and then simply push back into position. Then the final bit is a chrome strip. It just hooks in at the end. Just hooks in here. Hooks in there. And simply push snap. And that is your door reassembled.